Good afternoon, Olia.
Hello, Willie. How are you today?
I'm fine. I'm fine. Thank you. And welcome everybody to come to our podcast
Hello,
today.
everybody. Welcome.
And so Olia, do you want to maybe just introduce yourself a little bit?
Yeah, for sure, Lee. Thank you for asking. Hello, everyone. I'm Olia from Ukraine. I'm 14 years old and I go to middle school. Actually, maybe it's considered as a high school. So my goal right now is to learn English to a native speaker level, and I'm gonna move to English spoke country later in the future.
And it is important because you are also an English teacher.
Oh yeah, that's my
Yes.
secret. Yeah, I've been teaching English for a few months, maybe 3 months, since the summer, and I take private lessons with some of my students online. Yeah, so I think it's very nice.
So, for me, like you are already some kind of successful young entrepreneur. I think there's something I'm very interested in because when I was in your age, I wasn't, even begin making anything. And so I'm very curious, like you would like to talk about like when you began to learn English and thinking about being a teacher, like what is your motivation? And yeah, you want to talk about
Yeah,
that?
for sure. Learning English and building like my own kind of business on my lessons, it's two different stories, but it's all connected to English, one thing, English. So, as I remember, I started learning English. It was summer 21 or summer 22, 2022. I started because I was so motivated. I have watched a lot of videos about the USA, about Los Angeles, about Florida, Las Vegas, like big cities, and I was very patient about it. I thought like when if I learned English, I would go to the USA in about maybe 5 years, in 10 years, and I can live there, and I can build my career. So I started with really simple tasks, just some words, basic phrases, and then I watched some videos, I listened to native speakers, and later I started developing, and also because my English was around A2 to B1, I found a good friends who were very friendly. Some of them were from Europe, from the USA, and now I still keep in touch with them. I still have a close bond with them. So they were so friendly and they helped me on this way, this hard way. And I think that's why my English improved so much those times.
So approximately, like when you begin to improve yourself,
When I think I began, it was like epidemic of self-development videos, epidemic of motivation. I don't know, but I remember watching a lot of videos about self-development, like you have to wake up at 6, you have to take a cold showers, you have to go run, you have to go to do some exercises. It's like about self-development. I think it was 2 years ago,
2 years
around that.
ago.
Yeah, when I was 13. Now I'm 40, around maybe 1.5 years ago. I don't really remember, but I tried to do something to build my kind of business, to build myself, to build a successful person. So I read a lot of books. I was writing a lot. I was journaling. I was, walking on the street. I was running. I was learning English. I had a schedule, like a busy schedule, and I followed that schedule. So I was very focused. But then later it just went out and I became just a little bit lazy, but then I got back my motivation. You understand?
I see, I see. So, like the reason you can improve so well, like, what Do you have some kind of principle you follow, like to improve yourself?
One principle that I mentioned, I have really, it's I realized, like, I started mm-hmm. doing something, and I realized, like, I made a habit. I was learning English straightly for mm-hmm. 1 month straightly, without skipping any day. And mm-hmm. I realized if I right now break this habit, it will just ruin everything, because mm-hmm. I have been building this schedule, this habit for 1 or 2 months, and now mm-hmm. I will just break it. So I had one principle: doesn't matter what happened to me, doesn't matter where I am, but I always learn English at least 15 minutes, 1 hour, mm-hmm. 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. I mean, doesn't matter, but as much as I can, because it will give me a lot of benefits in the future. So I knew that, and I was moving towards that goal.
Mm. So culturally, would you say, like, because you're from Ukraine, yeah? So
yeah.
Would you say there are lots of like Western or American culture influence in your culture, like?
Yeah, I understood your question. I mm. don't really think English is popular or American culture is popular in general in okay. my country right now.
Mm.
I think we try to, provide, we try to advertise our own culture in Ukraine, like Ukrainian mm. culture, because
that's
I like
right.
it so much. Yeah, that's so interesting. I think, what about English? Only a few people know English, for example, well, in my city, who can speak fluently. Maybe mm. at school, some tests, but I'm just talking about, like, real English, you know, English that
That's
you
right.
use every day.
Yes, yes.
Yes. But in general, I don't think it's that common. Mm. I think maybe, like, Poland, Polish culture is more popular, but American culture, I don't think so.
Hmm. Yeah, because this would be something affect your study, yeah, your learning, and because if you just follow the education from your school, you probably don't reach high level English. Yeah, you have to
no.
make your own effort and.
Yeah, that's a big problem. Just to let everyone know, at my school we still learn past simple or present perfect, sounds like that. I don't really understand what we learn right now, because
mm-hmm.
I don't really listen to my teacher, because I think those materials are useless, because they don't really teach you English, you know. They teach you some grammar rules, like when to use past simple or present simple, but they don't give you practice. You don't mm-hmm. practice at all. You just take a theory, you just take it, like, take it away, take it inside, take it in, and then you just, in a few days, months, you just take it away, like, you forget about it.
Mm.
You forget completely about it.
Yeah.
So, I think that's a big problem, you know. School can teach you English, like,
mm.
Spoken English, you know, like native speaker English.
Mm.
Only you by yourself can do this, you know. But okay, for about you, when you was moving to an English spoken country, how did you learn English?
I was absolutely miserable. So I can say the English education back home in Taiwan was really, really terrible. So when I first moved to the UK, I couldn't understand anything, almost everything, you know, and I couldn't speak well because I don't have the muscle memory. Yeah, what I did. So I think one thing I did that would be different from other people, other classmates, was I tried to join the local life. So I tried to live like the British. For example, I would go and play football. No, not soccer. Soccer is here, but football in Britain.
Yeah, football.
So during the game, and I was also not very good at, you know, playing football, but doesn't matter. I just joined them. So then I tried to communicate with them, try to understand what are they doing. Yeah. So basically, I tried to understand except the classroom, what kind of English are they using? Yeah. And most of the time, I just trying to see if I can understand based on the context, the scenario. So although I couldn't understand the language well, but at the time, because my approach, I think I meet some local people, and I think that helps a lot. Because if I didn't meet those local people, I will probably just hang out with a Taiwanese or, you know, a Chinese speaker. That's not going to help, you know, the development. Yeah. So I think that I continue doing that until coming to Canada. So basically, I try to basically understand their culture, but there are a lot of, you know, languages about the culture. Yeah. You understand how they think in a different scenario, why they use the word. So it was interesting. I just talked with my brother about this movie. So there's a movie called Scent of Women. I don't know if you watch this movie, Al Pacino, and I think Christopher something. Like, it was a movie, and there's a movie scene. So, okay, so this is an old man and a young man, yeah? They're sitting in the table in a restaurant. And the restaurant is big. So they have this open court, like, you know, where people can dance, like a ballroom, you know. And there's a lady sitting alone waiting for someone, you know. So this old man is blind. Can I see? So he has asked the young guy, say, "So what are you looking right now?" He said, "There was a lady waiting for someone." And he say, the old man say, "Oh, you say lady, you like her." See, this is a very interesting, very subtle, you know, small stuff. Like, if I did a mistake, like, you know, there's many things. Only if you understand the culture, you understand the, you know, the context, then you can use it properly. Yeah. So yeah. That I think, you know, without, you know, living in the environment and actually have contact with the local people is hard to understand. Yeah.
Yes, that's for sure. So Lee, how long did it take you to improve your English from A0 to B1, maybe to B2, to speak fluently?
I think it's not easy to estimate the time because, you know, even though the education in Taiwan wasn't very good in English, but we still took a long time, yeah, to build the foundation. So whatever the vocabulary or grammar, you know, you went through, it was a long time. Like, we start to learn English, I think in high school, I think junior high school.
Only in high school?
From high school, yeah, begin from the high school. So it was a long time, yeah, until the time I went to the UK. I think it was already, like, I would say, yeah, more than 10 years in English education. Long time, yeah?
Actually, in Ukraine, we start learning English from the third grade.
Okay. Already. A bit earlier, yeah. But still, you know, it was a long time. But the result, when I went to the UK, I still couldn't speak. Yeah.
Yeah, that's true, because you didn't have, you know, skills to speak.
Exactly. So it's like I have to learn again, you know, from the bottom up. But I would say, even though those 10 years, education still maybe help a little bit, yeah, because you still have certain foundation. So you learn and you can catch whatever, you know, you need to, you know, because at the time I had to pass the IELTS test. 6.5 to be able to enter the university, yeah. So I have 3 months somewhere I have to improve. So I think that helped. But that was the time I actually feel like I'm actually learning English. Yeah, actually speaking.
Yeah, that's because you were in English spoken country, yes?
Exactly, yeah. That's why like I would never like reach like your level in your age, yeah? Like because when I was in Taiwan, like it would be really difficult to imagine if I can speak English so well at the time. So which means like when you graduate from university, you will be already speaking like, you know, really, really good, yeah? So that's, I think that's a way, yeah.
Yeah, I think so. You know, in my plans are like that. I want to learn one more language. You know, in general, in my life, I want to know 5 languages. Mm. For example, first language, I know Ukrainian, then I know Russian, mm-hmm. then I know English. And I want to know like 2 more languages. Mm-hmm. Maybe it will be Spanish. One, it will be Spanish. The other one, maybe Italian. I'm not sure. Maybe or Polish. I don't know. But in my plans, 2 languages.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So since we're talking about your early time, like except the English, the language, what actually influenced you? You know, for your decision making, you're thinking about life, you know, like what, if you record the memory, what influenced you?
Have one very big influence that I think really moves me against my fears and other things like laziness, I don't know. That's the fear of the future, you know, because mm-hmm. Of course we can predict the future, that's obviously, but to make it better, to make it you know, successful sometimes. So what I really realized is that we have to make you know, hard work right now. We have to work hard in general right now, mm-hmm. because later in the future, if you don't work, will be harder. So I decided right now, I can work right now. Still, I can work hard because I have time. Mm-hmm. I'm not a adult, so I don't have to care about bills. I don't have to care about what to eat. Mm-hmm. I don't have to care about what like how to pay for water. That's my parents do that. Yeah. I can focus on on my own personal goals. Mm. So what moves me is that like desire of success, and what moves me is that I want to be unique, because you know, I don't want to be like other teenagers in my age. I want to be unique and create my business in my young age.
And you want to be extraordinary. Yeah
I think so. I want to be unique, yes. Mm. I want to be something more. Maybe I'm not talking about that I want to be an English tutor in the future, no. Mm. I think I don't want to be a tutor at all. I don't think it's mine. But I want to connect my life somehow with English, with business, you know. So I think it's a good experience right now in
my career. Yeah. I think that's a very good introduction. So next time we can, you know, continue this topic. So basically, I think there are also lots of influence from other fields. Yeah. For example, there must be some kind of cultural influence. You mentioned the States. You mentioned other things. It can be, I don't know, it can be a movie, it can be music, it can be, you know, based on your culture. There's something to, because this episode we are going to make will be really about you. You are a special person, and we'd like to know, you know, your philosophy and your attitude toward the world and the life. So today we have this basic introduction about basically focus on the language. But next time we can elaborate a little bit more, okay?
Yeah, okay, so everybody, bye-bye. Thank you so much for joining our podcast.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, and thank you, Olia. We'll see you next time.
Thank you, Lee. Thank you, Lee, so much.
Ciao.
Bye.